Yeah, in today's topic, what all we are going to see: eligibility, cessation, resignation, motion of no confidence, co-option, casual vacancy, other related matter, and recap. And the first thing is eligibility under section 154B. We all know that 154B has been introduced by the government only for cooperative housing society, culled out from the overall cooperative. So the first thing what we are going to see is not eligible to be appointed, nominated, elected. ऐसा पढ़ना चाहिए इसको कि जो eligible नहीं है ये छोड़ के बाकी सब eligible है. That is why the law they are very clear in telling who is not eligible, who don't fall under this category, they all are eligible. If he is a defaulter, अगर defaulter हो, he is not eligible. कब तक? Says the time he pays his dues, he becomes eligible. If he carries on business letting, subletting, selling of flat in housing society of which he is a member. अगर ये member का, ये society का member है and he is into subletting of flat and selling of flat as a broker, he cannot become the managing committee member. If he has been responsible under section 154B(8)(2), that is not providing the requested information from member within the stipulated time, or 88, or for payment of cost of inquiry under section 85. ये particular चीज जो है, it is very elaborately given in the bylaw. ये क्या बोलना चाहता है? अगर the registrar has already been held him responsible for these things. One is not providing the required information to the member on time, or audit related inquiry, special inquiry related under section 88 and 85 mein, ye if a member is already held responsible or he is yet to reply, then he is not eligible to be the member. Then disqualification under 73 CA, having children more than 2, ये recent amendment में आया था, I think 2019 में ये 14 में किया था ये. So these are the things where the member is not eligible. Then ये category, first category जो देखा है defaulter का, बाकी तीन category में if the member is disqualified or not eligible in the midst of the tenure, then he is not eligible to be re-elected, co-opted, re-nominated for the 5 years from the date where he is not eligible. So, sir, would you like to add something here?
Yeah. See, now when we say like not eligible, now it's like, you know, for example, if the member is doing a business, it says that carries on business of letting, subletting. अगर खुद का फ्लैट अगर बेचना चाहते हैं और रेंट पे देना चाहते हैं, that is not a disqualification. But as a business, if somebody is doing it, okay, in बहुत सारे societies में देखने को मिलता है, secretaries are, you know, acting like, you know, brokers. Now that is a clear disqualification actually. Okay, and he has been held responsible. Now who can make him responsible? Only the registrar. Registrar has powers. Okay, under section 88, you know, which says that any delinquency, matlab any wrongdoing agar kar raha hai society mein, agar wo registrar ke paas leke gaye hai hum log, matlab society ka members, and registrar has really, you know, adjudged the respective committee member as disqualified, then he becomes disqualified. Or for payment of cost of inquiry under section 85, agar court mamla chal raha hai and then court has really, you know, made him pay some money, you know, as a cost of, you know, inquiry under, I mean, he's been just, you know, made to really inquiry mein agar atke hai, then in which case he becomes disqualified. And as ma'am said, like, you know, more than 2 children agar hai, okay, and there are so many other things. For example, you know, second agar delivery agar twins hai, to total 3 children ho jate hai, to now is a disqualification. Those are all different subject matter altogether. Okay, we will not get in there, but as per law, it's what it is says. What it said is, if any member, any, you know, managing committee member, if he has got more than 2 children, it may, okay, it may call for disqualification on the face of the law. Okay, this is 73 CA, you know, says talk about it. And ma'am also distinguished, matlab jitna sare diye hue hai, the first one, okay, that is default agar kiya gaya hai, till the time he doesn't, you know, pay up the dues, disqualification will be there. The moment he pays up the dues, then the disqualification is removed. Okay, in rest of the cases, that means through the action of the registrar, agar kuch hota hai aisa, then 5 saal ke liye he cannot be re-elected or re-co-opted or re-nominated for 5 years. Yeah, yes ma'am, go ahead.
The next one is cessation. Cessation per se, the actual English meaning is the member ceases to be qualified. That is the cessation, ceases, okay. Has he incurred any of the disqualification mentioned in the earlier slide? Agar earlier slide mein jitna bhi hai, wo, agar if he is disqualified means he ceases to be a member. He has failed to attend any 3 consecutive monthly meeting of the committee without leave of absence. And we all know that the managing committee is, managing committee can take n number of meetings, but at least once in a month the meeting is compulsory. If 3 consecutive meeting, if a member is not attending without a leave of absence, that is without any intimation, without any proper reason, then he is disqualified. If a member of a committee attracts any of the disqualification, the committee shall record the fact in the minutes of its meeting, and the secretary of the society shall inform the member and register accordingly. Such member shall cease to be a member of managing committee on the order of the registrar. And we all know that it's a panel of members, right? And this disqualification can be for a particular member or 2 members. So what will happen is, agar ye disqualify hota hai, the proper reason should be minuted in a minutes book, and it should, the secretary should sign it, and it should be informed to the registrar, and registrar will take a call whether he is properly disqualified or not. This is what the cessation says.
All right. So now, yep, this is not something like, you know, but there are 2 things. And if he's incurred any disqualification mentioned in the earlier slide, that is there. It's both of them exclusive. Like if either this or this, it's not that both of them, or he has not attended. Any one of them, you know, can become a, you know, he ceased to be. Now he has already disqualified under any one of these rules, and he's also not attending, you know, consecutively 3 meetings, then he is ceased to be a member. Okay, ceased to be a managing committee member. Okay, and that call who can take? Not the chairman, not the secretary, or the committee, or the general body. It is the registrar who will take a call. In the sense, like he adjusts just the MC member as he sees to exist as an MC member. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Next comes the resignation. See, a person can or has all his rights and will to resign the committee at any given point of time. The resignation may be due to health issues, or he must be getting transferred, or he might not be having enough time and doing justice of time to the committee. And there are many other reasons, any family issues, personal issues, anything. So resignation may, they have already put it into 3 category. 3 category mein kya hai? First one is the committee member, second one is the chairman, third one is the secretary and the treasurer. What is the procedure for each and every person to resign is very clearly given in the act. So agar committee member ko resign karna hai, he has to give a letter addressed to the chairman that the reason of he resigning, and by way the letter, the date of letter says it all. So in turn, the chairman is supposed to accept or reject. So acceptance letter or 30 days, whichever is earlier, the committee member resigns, or he ceases to become the committee member. Now the chairman is the CEO of like a company, right? So here he will be giving the letter to the secretary, and acceptance. Here it is mere acceptance in the committee member. Whereas when it comes to chairman, it is handing over of the charge to the new chairman up to the satisfaction. Papers go, all the minutes book, everything. There are set of records, keys, and there will be certain things kept, like even in the computer angle, if you see where the files are kept, which are the cupboard keys you have left, and what is the procedure, who are the employees. There are many things, there are many checklists over there. And this particular handover has to happen by the chairman to the new chairman. Only letter is not enough. Same way, the secretary or the treasurer should give a letter to the chairman, and same, acceptance and handing over the charge. This is very, very important. Now, resignation of the entire committee. Idhar kya dekha hum log? Individually dekha. Idhar entire committee resign kar raha hai. Kya karna hai? Place a request before general body meeting. General body meeting mein request place karna hai that we all are stepping down as whole. Then the general body has to accept. Then only it will go through. Then communication to the registrar. However, the existing committee shall continue to carry on with only routine functioning of the society till alternate arrangement is made by the registrar. Now, registrar will intervene and say what has to be done. He might bring in the new committee, or he might take some people from the existing committee. That is his prerogative, okay, what he has to do. Now, once the registrar comes, his decision is final. Now, what do you mean by routine functioning? Routine function to band nahi hona chahiye na, the issuance of check, the normal payment, whichever is there. These are the things which has to continue so that the society smoothly functions. Whereas there are major decisions they will not take, like collection of any new funds for the major repair fund, or any SGM calling for. These are the things they will not do. Whereas the routine work, they can continue where the normal operations of the society is not hampered. Yeah, this is all about the resignation of the member and resignation of the entire committee, sir.
Yeah, first one, we have just seen the eligibility. Second one, I mean, how, when he will cease to be a member of the managing committee. And okay, well, one important thing, see now there are, I mean, once I purchase a flat or a unit, I become a member, right? But now we are talking about managing committee. It's not that all the person or every person who purchases a flat or a unit can be, he is a member of the society, right? But we are talking about managing committee. That means who have really stood in the elections, who want to be a managing committee member. That we have already seen, like either 7, 9 or 11, 13, they're all odd numbers that we have seen. Maximum is 19 that we have seen earlier, right? So now those people we are talking about, now those people we have really seen how they, what is the eligibility for them, rather what makes it not eligible for to be a managing committee member, that we have seen, okay? And how one gets to see, I mean, cease to be a member of the committee member, wo dekha hai. Now the next is resignation. Resignation, individually kaise hai, agar मेंबर अगर करना चाहते हैं तो वो चेयरमैन को दे सकता है. अगर चेयरमैन खुद रिजाइन करना चाहता है, देन ही हैज टू जस्ट गिव इट टू द सेक्रेटरी. ओके, सेक्रेटरी या ट्रेजरर अगर नो रिजाइन देना चाहते हैं, देन द नो पर्सन टू हुम दे हैव टू गिव इज द चेयरमैन. ओके, इट्स लाइक थ्री आउट ऑफ थ्री, लाइक हूएवर इज देयर, लाइक दिस द नेक्स्ट इंचार्ज फॉर चेयरमैन इज सेक्रेटरी. वेरी क्लियरली इट इज विजिबल आउट हियर. ओके, सो नाइट नो, बट for the chairman and the secretary or a treasurer, okay, it's not just acceptance, okay, it's also handing over the charge. Like kisi aur ko bhi, maybe ad hoc committee ko matlab dena hai charge, nahi to kisi matlab elected committee ko dena hai, whatever is the decision of the person to whom it is been given to. In the case of a chairman, the secretary will take a call. In the case of a secretary or a treasurer, chairman will take a call as to whom should the handover to happen. Okay, and for a committee member, acceptance or rejection immediately, I mean, or if no decision has been taken by the chairman, within 30 days it is deemed to be accepted. So for a normal committee member, this is what we have seen. Now whole committee wants to resign, you know, lock, stock and then barrel, right? Like whole committee wants to just resign, in which case the governing board, I mean, kisko denge, kisko report karenge to general body. Okay, they have to call for a general body meeting. Okay, maybe a special general body meeting, or if AGM is coming through, yes, they can, and they have to put a request, make a request. Okay, now subject to the approval by the GB, acceptance or non-acceptance. Okay, either way, if it is accepted, then it has to be intimated to the registrar. Then registrar will take a call. It's like maybe he will just appoint an administrator for the society, or he may ask them to continue for some more time, or he may just choose, he may elect, come and conduct elections again in the society. That his decision is, you know, final and very clear, right? So this is what it says. Now in case if the, but till the time this alternate arrangement has been made, ma'am has very very clearly brought out, like regular day-to-day activities of the society should continue. What does that mean? Regular day-to-day collection of, you know, the maintenance and spending, so that the, you know, the society is run properly, is maintained properly. Okay, I mean, it should not get stopped. Okay, that's most important thing. Yes.
Then coming to motion of no confidence, section 154B of 24, how clearly it has been given. In fact, when it comes to the motion of no confidence, not entirely it has been changed. It has been copied from the earlier law only. There is no much of a difference between the earlier clause and the 154B clause for the housing society. Okay, there is only minor changes. That is why they have put it in 154B. Applicable only member tenure greater than 6 months. Now, what is member motion of no confidence? In the managing committee, there are members who have to be removed, but because they have no confidence on that person that this person will be eligible to continue, or he is not a right person whom we have elected or selected. So there comes to motion of no confidence. So it is not so you call a person and you say we don't have a confidence in you and you are moved. No, there is a specific process which has to be followed. Wo process kya hota hai? Pehli cheez jo hai, minimum 6 months hona chahiye for the member after he has been elected. Okay, very clear. 6 months hona chahiye on the board after the member has come. And notice given by 1/3 of the managing committee member, because it is the decision taking inside of the managing committee. So 1/3 of the member should raise this issue. Meeting presided by the registrar or deputy registrar rank will be there. And this 1/3 of the member will be reporting to the registrar saying that we want to pass a motion of no confidence against this person. In that meeting, which is presided by the registrar, 2/3 of the managing committee should agree fast. In that, registrar will not vote. He doesn't have voting right. Registrar will have only the presiding right. And the minutes of the meeting prepared accordingly, and that position is kept vacant. Now that vacancy will come in the vacancy, how it will be filled in. Okay, now if in that meeting, if the motion of no confidence is rejected, for next 1 year they cannot pass the motion of no confidence on that person. Okay, agar wo meeting mein that prove hua this person is confident and he has no blame, or he can support the committee, then for 1 year they cannot go in for motion of no confidence. This is the process which is laid by the MCS Act.
Okay, I mean, now we get to see like even the society is also just follows the principles of democracy, right? How what happens in the state assembly or a center, the same way even in the society. Agar ye office bearers ke upar hamara confidence nahi hai, हमारा मतलब ये मैनेजिंग कमिटी मेंबर्स का कॉन्फिडेंस, मतलब किस चीज का कॉन्फिडेंस, मतलब वो बोल नहीं पाते हैं, उसका लैंग्वेज ठीक नहीं है, वो काला है, वो गोरा है, नो, नॉट फॉर दीज रीजंस। इफ द मैनेजिंग कमिटी मेंबर्स नो दे फील दैट जिसके लिए उनको अपॉइंट किया गया है, अगर उनका रोल्स एंड रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज ठीक तरह से वो डिलीवर नहीं कर पा रहे हैं, एंड ऑल दैट व्हाट ही इज डूइंग इज अल्ट्रा वायरस, मतलब नॉट इन द इंटरेस्ट ऑफ द सोसाइटी, नॉट इन द इंटरेस्ट ऑफ द मैनेजिंग कमिटी, अगर कुछ कर रहे हैं तो देन द नो कॉन्फिडेंस मोशन कैन बी मूव्ड। ओके, नाउ ये भी क्या है, 6 महीने के लिए मतलब कुछ नहीं कर सकते, मतलब आज सेक्रेटरी बन गया, चेयरमैन या ट्रेजरर बन गया, नाउ व्हेन द मैनेजिंग कमिटी वांट्स दैट वी वांट टू रिमूव हिम, वेरी सेकंड डे डजंट वर्क बिकॉज़ द लास्ट इज लाइक वेरी मिनिमम 6 मंथ्स टाइम तो होना चाहिए, उसको 6 महीने का टाइम तो देना चाहिए टू डिलीवर द रिजल्ट्स टू द बेस्ट सेटिस्फैक्शन ऑफ द मैनेजिंग कमिटी। अगर वो नहीं हुआ है, बहुत कुछ बोल चुके हैं हमले, बिकॉज प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ नेचुरल जस्टिस इज ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। ओके, इन दैट 6 मंथ्स मैनेजिंग कमिटी मेंबर्स हैव टू मेक एन एफर्ट ऑफ ब्रिंगिंग इट टू हिज अवेयरनेस बाय हैविंग अ कंसल्टेशन कॉन्वर्सेशन विद देम, टॉकिंग विद देम, बोलना चाहिए ये है, ये है, ये है, वो है। उसका बावजूद अगर नहीं होता है, देन मिनिमम 1/3 ऑफ मैनेजिंग कमिटी मेंबर्स शुड पुट अप अ नोटिस ऑफ नो कॉन्फिडेंस। ओके, देन इट शुड बी जस्ट सेंट टू द रजिस्ट्रार एंड रजिस्ट्रार विल जस्ट विल गिव अ शेड्यूल टाइम, ओके ये डेट पे मैं आ रहा हूँ आपको सोसाइटी में। अगर वो और उनका डेप्यूटी जो भी है, उसका डेप्यूटी यू नो रजिस्ट्रार है, असिस्टेंट रजिस्ट्रार है, बट मिनिमम इज असिस्टेंट रजिस्ट्रार रैंक तक होना चाहिए। ओके, एंड दिस मीटिंग हैज टू बी पास्ड बाय एटलीस्ट 2/3 ऑफ द कमिटी, आई मीन मैनेजिंग कमिटी मेंबर्स, राइट। इसके बाद ही ओके मिनट्स ऑफ द मीटिंग हो जाएगा। देन अगर ये 2/3 मेजोरिटी नहीं है, देन इट कैन नॉट बी, आई मीन इट इज, आई मीन द नो नो कॉन्फिडेंस मोशन इज रिजेक्टेड, एंड नेक्स्ट 1 ईयर तक ये नहीं हो सकता है। फर्स्ट 1 ईयर मिनिमम 6 मंथ्स ऑफ टाइम, अब नेक्स्ट 1 ईयर इफ इट इज नॉट पास्ड विद द 2/3 ऑफ मेजोरिटी, देन इट कैन नॉट बी द सेम, नो कॉन्फिडेंस मोशन कैन नॉट बी पुट अप अगेन, टेकन अप अगेन फॉर नेक्स्ट 1 ईयर इज व्हाट द लॉ सेज, राइट। यस, राइट।
या इसमें और एक चीज है कि पर्सनल रिवेंज इसमें बीच में नहीं लेके आना है, फॉर एनी पर्सनल रीजंस नो मोशन ऑफ नो कॉन्फिडेंस कैन नॉट बी ब्रॉट इन द मिडिल, दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। या सर वुड यू लाइक टू गो विद को ऑप्शन एंड कैशुअल वैकेंसी, हाउ द प्रोसीजर एंड एवरीथिंग इज गॉन?
या आई डोंट माइंड।
या
ओके, को-ऑप्शन एक फैसिलिटी भी है, आई मीन फॉर एग्जांपल, और कैजुअल वैकेंसी भी हो सकता है, बिकॉज़ सी नथिंग इज परमानेंट, राइट। एज मैम जस्ट टू स्टार्ट विद सेड लाइक, अगर अब मेरा गवर्नमेंट का नौकरी है तो मेरा जस्ट ट्रांसफर हो गया यू नो नागपुर में फ्रॉम मुंबई, और वाइस वर्सा, और यू नो समबडी, आई मीन आई जस्ट यू नो समबडी द मेंबर यू नो डाइस, ओके नाउ दैट पर्टिकुलर कैजुअल वैकेंसी वैकेंसी अरेज होता है, तो उसका कैसे करे, और खुद के लिए वो कुछ मेडिकल रीजंस के वजह से उन्होंने रिजाइन किया है, तो देयर इज अ कैजुअल वैकेंसी जस्ट अराइज, नाउ व्हाट व्हाट टू वी डू। तो वन इज द को ऑप्शन फैसिलिटी इज देयर, ओके, को ऑप्शन फैसिलिटी इज व्हाट इट सेज इज दैट द एग्जिस्टिंग कमिटी मेंबर्स कैन को ऑप्ट देमसेल्व्स, ओके, फ्रॉम एनी ऑफ द एक्टिव मेंबर्स फॉर फिलिंग अप द वैकेंसी। अगर वैकेंसी है, खड़ा है, तो एनी ऑफ द एक्टिव मेंबर, सो एक्टिव मेंबर का डेफिनेशन इससे पहले हमने दिया है, आई मीन की वेयर यू नो ही शुड बी पेइंग द ड्यूज यू नो प्रॉपरली, द मेंटेनेंस ड्यूज, एंड यू शुड बी अटेंडिंग ऑल द यू नो व्हाट यू कॉल एजीएम्स, ओके, ही शुड नॉट हैव, एक्चुअली व्हाट द लॉ सेज इज ही शुड नॉट हैव नॉट मिस्ड एटलीस्ट 5 consecutive यू नो एजीएम्स, एंड ही शुड नॉट बी अ डिफॉल्टर more than 90 days is what the active member definition says earlier, okay. Now he should be active member, that means he should be paying the proper maintenance dues, and at the same time he should be actively attending, okay, all the managing all the you know AGMs and stuff like that. So created by resignation, cessation and death. Yes, I mean the casual vacancy kaise arise hota hai, kaise utpann hota hai, agar resign kiya hai or ceased to be a member ho gaya hai or death kisi wajah se. प्रोसीजर क्या है, ओके, कॉल फॉर एप्लीकेशन थ्रू नोटिस, स्क्रूटिनी, सिलेक्शन, फॉर्म फिलिंग, इंटीमेशन टू द रजिस्ट्रार, Okay, procedure is simple, like, you know, whosoever wants, now the society has to put up in the notice board, like, yeah, we have a vacancy here. Okay, the eligible interested members, okay, can put up their application. Once you get the application, scrutinize karo, select karo, the managing committee will take a decision on the selection of ab kisko select karna hai. Then jaise selection ho gaya hai, form fill up karo uska. As a managing committee member ka jo form fill up, jo form jo hota hai, wo fill up karwa lo. Then intimation to the registrar, kyunki humne ye co-option karke ye wala ek एक वैकेंसी अरेज हुआ था, उसका ऐसे फिलअप किया करके वो प्रोसीजर रजिस्ट्रार को देना है. ओके, द टर्म इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, मतलब जिसने सीज किया, मतलब जैसा वो वैकेंसी कैजुअल वैकेंसी अरेज हुआ है, उनका टर्म जितना भी था, उनका जगह पे ये नया वाला जो ना बंदा आ रहा है, तो उनका इज लिमिटेड टू दैट एक्सटेंट ओनली. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, 2 साल हो गया है किसी का सीज टू बी ए मेंबर हो गया, काले बाकी 3 साल है. द न्यू मेंबर हु को ऑप्टेड एंड गेट्स इनटू दिस पोजीशन विल हैव अ टर्म ऑफ ओनली 3 इयर्स, बिकॉज़ बाकी जितना है उतना ही है. बट इट्स नॉट इक्वल टू समथिंग लाइक मैन, मैं आई हैव बिकम अ नाउ मैनेजिंग कमिटी मेंबर, आई शुड बी देयर एज अ मैनेजिंग कमिटी फॉर नेक्स्ट 5 इयर्स. ये नहीं चलेगा इन दिस केस. इन द केस ऑफ को ऑप्शन और कैजुअल वैकेंसी अगर अरेज हुआ है, इन दिस केस इट्स ओनली द टाइम left in that particular term jo hai wo wala milega. This is what the co-option or casual vacancy is all about. Yes ma'am.
Yeah, next is other related matters. Other related matters mein first thing is conflict of interest. So conflict of interest is very very important. Main ek example deti hu. Agar there is a big work going on, say for example there is a painting work going on and the work, it is worth 50 lakhs, okay, and if there is a person who is bidding for that contract and his existing management committee's relative, brother or sister or a known person or a friend or some relation who is there who is bidding, then he should not be allowed to take a decision or be in the matter where it comes to the painting contract of 50 lakhs. So this is called conflict of interest. Next, first meeting of the newly elected jointly with outgoing committee shall be held 30 days from the date of taking charge. Between two committees, handing over and taking over, the meeting should take place within 30 days of the joining of the new committee. Now, when it comes to quorum, earlier in 2014 bylaw, the quorum was like the total number of members, including the reserved category, the quorum was fixed 50% majority. But in the recent amendment, it is very very clearly told that only the number of members, that is, if the reserved category is not included, only the general category is there, upon that general category it can be 50% and the majority. The committee shall meet as often as necessary, but at least once in a month. This point we already told. And there may be any emergency where the society is not having time to meet, in that case they can take a call and do the work. For example, we had an example where the pipeline got broke, so immediately they have to spend money of 50,000 and they have to take a call. For that they can't do the meeting because all the people will be wanting, there is a problem of water. So in this case they have to take a decision in the upcoming meeting. They have to necessarily pass this whatever action taken. It's very very important. This is called emergency meeting. In this case, whatever decision taken can be put up in the next meeting and it has to be approved. Then only it comes at the approved matter in the board. Okay, yes sir, we can go for a recap.
No, just before that, just go to the previous slide.
Yeah, you want to go down.
Yeah, conflict of interest is very important. Now you get to hear, you get to see, like, many even judges, okay, they recluse themselves, okay, in hearing the case itself. Okay, because they have some vested interest in that particular case. Okay, they recluse themselves the same way. There is no difference. Like, you know, even the managing committee member, every managing committee member also holds a public office, because they are collecting the money from the public and they're spending. They have the authority to spend. So in a way, it's a public work that they're doing. Now, what ma'am has just brought out, very important thing, like, if there is somebody, like, now there is some contract is there for a society, and then that particular vendor who was actually given a quotation happened to be your friend or your relative, okay, then make sure that you're not there in the decision making meeting. Wo meeting mein jo bhi hai, agar tender opening up a tender is there, or making a decision, you know, to go with him or not to with him, whatever is the decision about the purchase, make sure that you recluse yourself so that you are not influencing the decision in any which way. Okay, it's very important. Okay, and because everything comes out of this, for example, any sort of interest hai, friend hai, relative hai, or anything other than, for example, you are working for a bank, for example, like, you want the deposits to be in your own bank. So now make sure that there is no vested interest there. Now give the choice to the managing committee and say that I work for this company, for this bank, and in no way that I want these funds to be in my bank. But I mean, if you choose to be, you know, put in the bank, yes, you can go ahead. So now make yourself very clear. So no way that your any of your transactions, any which way that you are actually regulating or bringing the conclusion to a particular, you know, level, that is all conflict of interest. Ye bahut bahut important hai. Okay, and the ma'am has just brought about something like, you know, quorum. So quorum mein ye bolna chahta hu, there are some reserve category agar wo banda nahi milta hai, like scheduled caste, scheduled tribe, agar wo vacancy rakhna hai as per the government, you know, notification. Now, for example, let us take 11 member. 11 members mein 4 people are reserved category, charo char koi nahi hai. So 11 minus 4 is only 7. So now 50% is a quorum means 50% of 11 or 50% of 7. Ma'am has very clearly, you know, clarified it's a 50% of 7, not the 11. Okay, this is the quorum for quorum. Matlab kya agar ye number of members agar quorum minimum nahi hai, 50% nahi hai, the decisions cannot be taken. That means agar, even if they are taken, they are not binding on the managing committee. Because see, it's all coming from the democracy. It's like majority wins. Okay, 50% or over and above 50% is the majority vote accordingly, right? I mean, according to the definition of democracy. Now, 50% of what? 11, which is the strength, you know, prescribed by the, you know, act. Or now there are vacancies because now the related people are not there, respective people are not there. So it's a active, only 7 or 8 are there. Out of that 50% is, you know, 4. At least minimum 4 should be there to take a decision to ratify. And ma'am also just brought about something like, you know, the managing committee member, I mean, meetings, minimum 1 in a month should happen. It's like minimum 12 in a year. Maximum number of, you know, meetings, there is no limit. Any number of meetings can happen. Now, ma'am also brought about something like very important. There is something like emergency committee. Agar samajh lijiye, once a month agar meeting ho raha hai, okay, now in the middle of the month or ek hafte ke baad ek managing committee meeting hua, ek hafte ke baad kuch emergency aa gaya, jaisa ki ma'am ne example liya hai ki matlab ye pipeline toot gaya hai, uska turant usko repair karwana hai, naya lagwana hai, uska cost hoga 50,000, 70,000, 1 lakh, for example. So now emergency meeting can be called for. Okay, we need not wait for the next committee meeting, which is next month. No, it can be called for immediately, and decision can be taken and then rectification can be done. But make sure that the next committee meeting jab kabhi hota hai, ye wala jo hai ye mudda wo rakha jaye aur ratification kiya jaye, matlab wo subsequent meeting mein wo sahi salamat endorse kiya jaye ki committee ne sahi salamat, yes, it was emergency, it was required, and then we ratify the actions taken by the emergency committee jo liya hai. So this is what the procedure, what the other related matters that were, you know, in and around. And let's look at, is there anything, Uma, in that?
Yeah, that's it. Now we are.
Let's look at, chat mein dekho, Uma ma'am, there are some questions are already.
After recap, we'll take the questions.
Okay, sorry. Okay.
Okay, so we saw eligibility, cessation, resignation. Resignation or cessation ka difference bhi dekha. Motion of no confidence, co-option of the casual, co-option kya hota hai, casual vacancy kya hota hai, and other related matters. So.